With Daryl Jackson and Bobby Engram sidelined by injury, Matt Hasselbeck turned to one of Tim Ruskell's free agent signings, Joe Jurevicius.
Now he lets it fly, and he's got a man downfield. He's got a catch. It's Joe Jurevicius down the left sideline. Matt, seven-step drop. Looks left, fired. He's got Jurevicius inside the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Seahawks. Holy smoke, where would they be without Joe Jurevicius?
Hi, guys. This week on Fridays at the Whiteboard, I wanted to take a look at pre-snap reads, late defensive moves, and then cover Joe Jurevicius's 2-touchdown performance against the Giants and how Seattle schemed him to one-on-one situations to win matchups to score touchdowns. Now, the interesting thing about pre-snap reads is they only work without late defensive moves, things that the Giants used to prevent Matt Hasselbeck from finding success in man-to-man coverage. Now, on this particular look, you have basically a 9-man box. The two safeties are back at the start of the play, and just before the snap, here's what the Giants are going to do to disguise their approach. As you see, their linebackers are on both ends of the line of scrimmage. So there's the middle linebacker and there are the two safeties back. Now what's going to happen is the strong safety is going to switch, the free safety is going to come up near the middle linebacker. So he's actually going to move up. So just draw an arrow. There you go. And the strong safety is going to replace him at center field. So they're basically going to do that. And this is going to prevent Matt from getting a good gauge on what's happening, because he doesn't know if these linebackers are going to stay home or if they're going to come on a blitz. And if these guys are rotating, he doesn't really know where he wants to go with the ball right away. That's the attempted disguise, so that, you know, a one-on-one situation isn't easier to gauge. Especially with Jeremy Stephens, DJ Hackett, and Bobby Engram all bunched in this area here. Though we have there's a little more space on the actual field than we possess here on the whiteboard. But so, here's how the play unfolds though. As the safety comes down at the snap and this guy rotates into center field, here are the concept routes that are run by Seattle. Stevens actually stays in to block. Okay, so he's actually just going to...
Make a line. Yep, perfect.
And then what DJ Hackett's going to do is he's going to run a go pattern. So he's going to run deep.
So you can go up and...
So maybe it's actually... Yeah, so he's actually going to run deep. You're right.
We'll just run through the...
Yep. And then what's going to happen is that's going to draw the strong safety out of center field. So he's going to go and greet Hackett. And Bobby Engram, he's just running around like a little short route here. Little clear pattern. The free safety's now pulled. What you have and what you wind up with is the linebackers don't come on a blitz, they decide to retreat into coverage. But what happens is there's no depth by this linebacker. You've done that right. There's no depth by this linebacker. He just turns, kind of gives a little, like he's going to drop into coverage, almost like he's spying Alexander out of the backfield. So what this provides is Joe Jurevicius in a one-on-one situation. And let me show you what happens. So the DB here is actually Corey Webster, 23, but we'll just leave him as DB because who cares, it's the Giants. So what Joe Jurevicius is going to do is he's going to run what's called a long crossing pattern.
So
what he's going to do is he's actually going to run like this. So it's a long, so start there and just draw, yep, and just get right in front. Perfect. So he's going to run this long crossing pattern. And with no safety in the middle of the field, there's nobody to help Corey Webster, who's now defending a go route right at the start of the snap. So he's trying to defend deep, knowing that he's not really going to have help to his side of the field. So his hips turn, Joe Jurevicius glides inside of his hips, and as he runs, he isolates Webster. So Webster winds up, just put like a dot or a star, like right here at the H. Right here at the H.
Oh, right here.
Mm-hmm. And Joe Jurevicius is actually going to catch the ball where Diana drew the point of the arrow, because what's going to happen is Matt's going to have to release the ball as he gets pressured by the nose tackle here, and he's going to have to release the ball, and Webster actually stops to try and catch the ball, but Joe Jurevicius, being 6'5", 230, and in a one-on-one situation, it's a jump ball, and Joe is going to win those a majority of the time. And this is all based on the fact that once Matt saw those safeties exchange positions, he knew he had a good shot at a one-on-one with Joe Jurevicius. In fact, the whole time, he's just waiting for Joe to get into that space, and that's the only reason he holds the ball on a seven-step drop. So that's the first touchdown I want to show you. There's a second 16-yard touchdown, and we'll be back after a short break. Welcome back. So, on the second touchdown that Seattle scores, now, to explain, to give this a little context, Seattle was really struggling. The Giants came in with the approach of, we're going to stop Sean Alexander, and we don't think you have anything else. Their receiving core was depleted. Bobby Engram, I think this was his first game back, and Matt Hasselbeck definitely wasn't on the same page with them. And so a lot of the Giants' schemes are built around stopping Sean Alexander. So what you continuously see throughout the game is that even when they try these spread formations or other things like that with three wide receivers, the Giants are leaving their linebacker on the field, which I don't even know who their nickel corner was, because I didn't think we saw him for a single play in this game. But here's what happens on the second touchdown. Seattle knows that it's gotten man coverage on the outside most of the game. So after a 20-yard run by Sean Alexander on a brutal cutback, Matt Hasselbeck immediately gets everybody to the line, and here's the concept they come up with. They run play action to Sean Alexander. So what Matt's going to do is he's going to come down, he's going to hit Sean. Sean's going to pull out, and he's gonna attract this linebacker. Okay? So that linebacker's going to stay home and pick up Sean. And what's going to happen now is Joe Jurevicius and this DB are going to go one-on-one. With the play-action sell, the safeties are now frozen. They don't know what they should do in terms of who they should take. The safety in terms of the stronger side of the formation, meaning which side has the most receivers, usually that safety's cheating down to kind of interrupt that with the weakness of having an extra linebacker. So the free safety's going to actually be in the middle of the field for this one.
He looked off to the side. That's why I wrote him like that, because mm-hmm. He was off to the side, New York.
He definitely was. Okay, so all of these routes don't matter, because right at the snap with the carrying of the linebacker, Matt knows now that he has a one-on-one. Even with the free safety in the middle of the field, this route, which Joe Jurevicius runs, which is absolutely beautiful, is a corner route. Now, Diana's going to draw that up for you. What he's going to do is he's going to run.
Go right through that linebacker.
Yep. Up and to the corner. And it's a beautiful route. It's run so well that Curtis DeLoach, who's the DB, is actually going to be peeking into the backfield on the play action. So he's going to be looking at Sean for most of this route. He's not. He's thinking Joe Jurevicius is going inside. And where he should normally just turn inside releases to the free safety and stay home, he's going to carry out on this, turn his hips, thinking, I need to carry this inside. Joe's simply going to cut it up. Matt's going to deliver the pass, and you have a 16-yard touchdown that's beautifully executed on a play action, getting a one-on-one and diagnosing that right away. And there you have it. Two nicely executed touchdowns by Joe Jurevicius in a brutal game where Seattle's big plays were limited and its running game practically eliminated. Okay, I will see you next week.